This is What's for Lunch Monday. We are having string beans, potatoes, and spare ribs with Sweet Baby Ray on top. It's a yummy lunch and we're looking forward to it. It's June 20th, 2017, and what's for lunch today is meatball subs and macaroni salad. Hi everyone, this is Tina, and it is June 21st, Wednesday, and this is what we're having for lunch today. Garlic shrimp with three cheese tortellini. And I got this recipe from allrecipes.com, and I'm going to scan the page. It's a really easy recipe, very delicious. It's a family favorite. So if you want to pause this, you can copy off the recipe or go to All Recipes and print it off. And I'm going to show you the recipe now. This is the three cheese tortellini that I bought at Aldi's. I have two packages that I'm going to be using, and I'm doubling the recipe. Now, if you hear some clanging around, it's Rachel. She's making some garlic bread for me. So I have the sous chef working, making that. So the water is almost ready to boil, and I'm going to dump these in here in a minute to get them cooking, and then we're going to start with the shrimp. I also get my extra virgin olive oil at Aldi's. So this recipe takes 4 tablespoons since I am doubling the recipe. And I really don't measure, I just kind of eyeball it. So there we go. I'm also using 4 teaspoons of chopped garlic, and I get this also at the Dollar Tree. It works great. So I'm just going to dump this in. Again, I'm not one to measure. So, looks good to me. We're going to get our olive oil and garlic going here. And then I'm going to throw in the shrimp. The tortellini is all done. So I just drained that. Okay, so we're cooking the oil and the garlic, and I'm going to add my shrimp. You can get any size shrimp you prefer. Your shrimp until they're nice and pink. It smells good in the house. I love garlic. While the shrimp is cooking, I'm going to stir the pesto into the tortellini. And then you're also going to put your basil and sun-dried tomatoes in the tortellini as well. Tortellini. put the sun-dried tomatoes in. And the basil. Could you get the pesto container for me, please? Wash it out. Thank you. Shrimp. They look good. And we can add those to the tortellini. Just a spoonful of this broth or two to kind of move the pasta, the pesto around just a little bit. And we will plate it up and it'll be almost time for lunch. And here is today's lunch. 3 cheese tortellini with shrimp and salad and garlic bread. Hi everyone, it is June 22nd and today's lunch is smoked sausage gnocchi with sun-dried tomatoes. Again, it is from allrecipes.com. I will scan the recipe quick so you can pause the video and write the recipe down. Or go to All Recipes yourself and print it off. It's an easy recipe. This is the first time I'll be making this, so we're anxious to try it. And that's what's for lunch. We're going to get cooking here soon. To make this recipe, you're going to need some beef smoked sausage, or any kind of sausage you can find. I got this at Aldi's. I think it was like $2.49. You will need some sun-dried tomatoes in oil, your gnocchi, which I got this at the Dollar Tree, some garlic, spinach, and Parmesan cheese. Now we're going to cut up our sausage while our water is boiling for our gnocchi. When our water gets to boiling, we're going to put our gnocchi in, and it just needs to cook till the water boils again, and then I pull it off and drain it. So we're going to cut up the sausage in small pieces, if I can get into it. Really seal it well. Like I said, I got this at Aldi's, where I get a lot of my groceries. If you all have an Aldi's, you need to check it out. It's a great store. It saves us a lot of money. I just wish the store was around when my kids were little, because we could have really used it then. And they were big eaters. I also got this plastic sheet at the Dollar Tree. These are great for over your cutting boards. And I'm going to cut this in small pieces. My sous chef, Bandit, is outside. So Gus is running around here in the kitchen. So you might see him in the background. He has been busy trying to catch a fly this morning. For our gnocchi, we have to have good boiling water. So I'm just letting it boil really hard, and then we're going to put the gnocchi in, and it has to reboil, and then we take it out and drain it. I'll put a little salt in this water. I'd say that's good. Be careful when you put it in there so you don't burn yourself. I'm going to stir these up a little bit just to break them up. And we have to wait for the boiling process again and then take them out. Drain them. And then we'll be putting them over here in the frying pan. Okay, the gnocchi is boiling, so that is ready to get pulled off the stove and drained and back into the pot again. We have our gnocchi all drained and we're keeping it warm over here. And so we're gonna start on our sausage and garlic and tomatoes and spinach. We're gonna put our sausage in first. And then our fourth of a cup of sun-dried tomatoes in oil. We found that at Walmart. We're going to put our garlic in next. And like I said, I'm not one to measure things, so I'm just going to eyeball it and dump it in. We like garlic, so that looks good. This around. I think it said to cook it for 5 minutes. Yeah, 5 minutes or till the sausage is lightly browned. So we'll set our timer for 5. And then I'll bring you back when we're ready to put the spinach in. Our sausage is nice and brown, so we're gonna put our spinach in. turn the heat down just a little bit. And I'm going to get this wilted and then I'll bring it back. The spinach is all nicely wilted and I'm going to put the gnocchi in next. Warm it up and it'll be time to eat. And the gnocchi is stuck. Going to warm the gnocchi up. And I'm going to put some Parmesan cheese on top. And it looks really, really good. Excited to try this. Alright, I'll bring you back when we have it plated. I just put the Parmesan cheese on top and we're gonna serve it up and I'll show you the plate in a minute. This is what's for lunch today. The Parmesan cheese with sausage, spinach, and gnocchi. Looks delicious. Hi everyone, I'm sorry that there is no Friday meal plan today. We got busy with a doctor's appointment and we just went and grabbed some Chinese buffet after we were done. Rachel had a doctor's appointment today because she's having some issues and she's not doing all that great. And so the next step for her is going to see a pediatric, cardiologist on the 21st of July. Because she's still having racing heart issues and all that other stuff. Plus she's not sleeping well. They changed some meds. Hopefully that'll help her sleep. Hopefully that'll cover some other issues that she's having. Let me see, what else do I have to update you guys on? Oh, Hershey. Hershey finally called after problems with our insurance. And finally have an appointment for Hershey for September the 8th. I know, September. Got to go through a stinking summer. Oh, I'm telling you, my nerves are about shot. And, you know, I know how this is getting to me. I can only imagine how it is for Rachel. Because she's the one that's sick and putting up with all of this, waiting. But at any rate, we continue to ask for prayers for her. I'm sorry my throat's off and on because I've talked a lot today and allergies are driving me crazy. And doing that did not help. Excuse me. Anyways, like I said, we ask you to keep her in our prayers. We would greatly appreciate it. And if you liked the recipes this week and you liked how I did them, please let me know. I'm trying to change things up a little bit and, you know, I value your input. Take care. Have a wonderful weekend. Till we talk next time. Bye.